dedicated to arts and culture. And now here's your host for the program, Kerry Frumpkin.
Thank you, Jan. If you decide to call your group Civitas, well, that's a pretty strong clue that you care deeply about your community. And since 2011, the idea of civic engagement has been a guidepost for our guests tonight. More about that later. The principal members of Chicago-based Civitas are here with us for this broadcast. Violinist Yuanqing Yu, cellist Ken Olson, and pianist Winston Choi. Along with violist Weijing Huang Michal, they will be playing three piano quartets, music by Mahler, Richard Strauss, and to begin, Mozart. By the way, you can see as well as hear this concert by visiting WFMT.com or WFMT's Facebook and YouTube channels. So up first tonight is K-487 by Mozart. The piano quartet was something new to Vienna in the mid-1780s, and it was a challenge to get this and its companion pieces published. Franz Anton Hofmeister initially financed three such works, but after seeing the results, he advised the composer to write more popularly, or else I can neither print nor pay for anything of yours. And Mozart's response was, "Then I will write nothing more and go hungry, or may the devil take me." As it turned out, Mozart managed to get the second of these quartets published by another publishing house, and the third he wrote just for himself. And Vienna audiences didn't receive K-478 well, probably because they associated piano and strings with casual salon occasions and amateur performances. This was not that sort of music. One critic summed up the situation perfectly. "What a difference when this much-advertised work of art is performed with the highest degree of accuracy by four skilled musicians who have studied it carefully in a quiet room where the sound of every note cannot escape the listening ear and in the presence of only two or three attentive persons." The piece is in three movements. They are marked Allegro, Andante, and Rondo. Here is the piano quartet number one in G minor by Mozart. Music by Mozart. The Piano Quartet No. 1 in G minor, K478, as performed by Civitas. The group is our guest tonight on WFMT. There is much more to come, music of Mahler and Richard Strauss, all piano quartets. That in a moment, but first we take a break. Jen? Hear music by Gustav Mahler. Well, Ching, can you, I have to ask this question of just about everybody I see, because we haven't been doing these live concerts because of COVID for quite a while, and I'd like to find out how you weathered the storm, so to speak. I talked earlier at the beginning about how Civitas is all about serving the community, bringing music to the community. In a way, you're doing that right now, of course. You're going to be performing this very music at Orchestra Hall tomorrow night, and the wider Chicago area gets to hear it this evening. But were you inhibited somewhat, or probably a lot?
I think for a little over a year, we didn't really do live concerts. So what we did was some virtual concerts like everyone else, and including some of our community outreach programs. So we worked with senior homes where they had the capacity to stream, or we did Zoom sessions. Just, we're pretty lucky, I think, being members of the Chicago Symphony, that we actually came back in October, I think, so 6-7 months after the pandemic started. We were back somewhat live on stage, but very spread apart with chamber concerts. They produced the CSO TV series. But for Civitas, we were out for a good over a year. Yeah, it was difficult.
That's rough. Are you out and about now, pretty much?
Yeah, we're back. And this year we have 8 live performances. And this is, I think, coming up on March 19th is our 6th one in the Rhapsody Theater. So that's in Rogers Park. Mm-hmm. It's a program really interesting that we're featuring our principal trumpet player in the orchestra, Esteban Batallan, in Saint-Saëns Septet, which is not very often played piece, but it's a joyful piece. And then a work that is readapted actually for Civitas and Estebam by Chicago composer James Stevenson. It's called Martha Uncaged. I think you probably know the original work, yeah. And now it's adapted for Civitas, the piano trio, plus Esteban. And then on the same program, we'll also be playing a couple pieces by another Chicago composer, Misha Zupko.
Sure.
It's somewhat a surprise, so I'm not going to say what we're going to play.
Okay.
But then we opened that program actually with Mozart piano trio in C major. So that concert is on March 19th at 2 o'clock at Rhapsody Theater.
How does one get tickets for all those good things?
So you can go on our website, civitasensemble.org, and there should be a tab saying buy tickets.
Okay.
Yeah.
And tomorrow night, of course?
Yeah, tomorrow night is actually CSO. It's a free concert. So you go on the CSO website, cso.org. I think search for all access concert. It's at 6:30, totally free.
Great. Well, what's coming up is free to hear as well, music of Mahler, because you're listening to us tonight. And this is unusual in that this is a chamber piece by Gustav Mahler, his piano quartet in A minor, which he wrote in 1876. It actually is his first known composition, and he wrote it as a student at the Vienna Conservatory. There really aren't a whole lot of suggestions as to where Mahler might go in the future that you can get from this piece, outside of the fact that it is dark, it is brooding, and there is a tendency here to make very quick transitions from one key to the next, all of those things happening later in Mahler's music as well, of course. There was never a publication of this piece during his lifetime. It was rediscovered by Alma Mahler in the 1960s and was only actually published in 1964. The manuscript consists of a complete first movement and then 24 measures of a scherzo in G minor. But no one is really sure that this was to be juxtaposed with the completed movement, but it did appear in the same folder when it was discovered, so people think that is the case. Here is Mahler's piano quartet in A minor. This movement is marked nicht zu schnell, or not too fast, and it's to be played for us by Civitas.
Thank you.
Gustav Mahler's Piano Quartet in A Minor, performed for us by Civitas. And they will be back in a moment with music of Richard Strauss. Jen? Father, who certainly steered him in a certain direction, but also quite specifically Johannes Brahms, especially in this piece. Winston, would you agree?
Yes, absolutely. I think this is a, even though it's such an early piece of Strauss's, it really sounds like the work of a very mature composer. I think it's full of inventiveness and innovations, as well as it carries over and continues many traditions, such as you just mentioned, with Brahms and his chamber music. So the music is very rich, it's thick. There's a lot of dialogue and conversation going on. But another thing I find quite interesting and unique about this particular piece is how well scored it is. You can already hear the master orchestrator at work. There's many different kinds of textures that are happening simultaneously, and interesting different types of articulation happening at the same time between contrasting groups of instruments. So despite its thickness, I think it really holds together really well. So it's expertly crafted and full of inspiration as well. You'll hear in the slow movement how inspired he already was at this youngish age.
He had this great talent, certainly for lyricism, and in that movement, it really, really shines through, I think. It's a gorgeous piece. It's in four movements. They're marked Allegro, Scherzo Presto, Andante, and the finale is marked Vivace. Here is Richard Strauss's Piano Quartet in C Minor, Opus 13.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
The Piano Quartet in C Minor, Opus 13 by Richard Strauss. Which brings us to the end of this concert by Civitas. Performing tonight were violinist Wan-Ching Yu, cellist Ken Olson, and pianist Winston Choi, along with violist Wei-Jing Wang Michal. They began the evening with the Piano Quartet No. 1 in G Minor, K478 by Mozart. And just before the Strauss, we heard the Piano Quartet in A Minor by Gustav Mahler. And you can see this program at Symphony Center tomorrow night, 6:30. Tickets are required, but they are free, and they can be gotten at the Symphony Center website. Civitas, by the way, has its Sounds of Chicago concert coming up on Sunday, March 19th. That is at the Rhapsody Theater. And you can find out more about Civitas by checking out the group's website. It is civitasensemble.org. Our thanks to these wonderful musicians for being with us tonight. Thanks also to my co-producer, Louise Frank, and to our music producer, Max Lebien. We had assistance tonight from Adela Skowronski, and thanks to her, we also had video of tonight's concert, and that can be found at WFMT.com or WFMT's Facebook and YouTube channels. We hope you can join us again next week when our guests will be cellist Anita Graf and pianist Louise Chan. I'm Carrie Frumkin, host and producer of these programs, hoping you'll be with us next Monday night at 8 for more music and performance live from WFMT.
You've enjoyed this. I'm from